Hi everybody, I'm Mom and I welcome you all to my channel Momda's Life Handmade. And today I welcome you all to the Useful DIY Challenge January 2020. And every month I have a co-host with me. This month's co-host is Liza Birmingham from Liza Birmingham. I thank Liza for hosting this channel this month with me. And I thank all the participants who are going to join this month and all the viewers who come to this challenge every month. This challenge is hosted almost every month. Once in a while, I have to give it a miss because of family or holidays or something like that. Otherwise, this is a monthly challenge that I host every month. And this month's theme is simple, Valentine's DIY. Make anything that you want to make for Valentine's. So there is a playlist link given in the description box below where you can go and add your video to the playlist, or you can add all the videos that have participated in the Useful DIY Challenge this month. If there is any problem adding your video to the playlist, as always, I say make some noise and I'll pick your video and add it to the playlist. My channel is all about DIY. It's specifically about picking something very ordinary, picking some kind of maybe trash to others, but which I feel has potential to change into something useful and beautiful. So I love doing lots of DIYs, decor, home recipes, so everything within a budget. And if that is something that you're looking for and you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel by hitting the red subscribe button given below the video or the icon given in the bottom right corner of the video, and hit the notification bell so that you're notified each time I post my video. My today's entry for the Useful DIY Challenge is a wine caddy or a beer caddy, or basically a caddy to hold items. I have seen this so many times in so many different videos and different sites, and I really love them. They have this vintage beauty about them. They are well constructed and they are very useful. They are also so very beautiful. And this kind of caddy is not so popular in my part of the world. Even if I get them very rarely in some very few high-end stores, they are overpriced to what they are made of really. So I decided to make one for myself. Now I gave it a little vintage, cottage kind of look, but I kept it very cheerful and I really love how it turned out. Let's get started. First of all, I would like to discuss my pattern, how I drafted it, so you can get an idea how to make it so that you can draft your own pattern with this. Taken a small beer bottle or a small sauce bottle, that is 500 ml sauce bottle or 330 ml beer bottle, as my reference size for the bottle. Now, keeping the bottle upright, I just drew a circle around its base to get how much wide it would be, and accordingly I decided how much wide my caddy should be. So therefore my pattern is like this, but the base I need a rectangle shape like this, so it is 3.5 inches by 6.5 inches. Now cardboard is very interesting, especially the packing cardboards which have a plain cover on the front and plain cover at the back, and in between are layers of corrugated sheets, and this gives it very much strength. Now if you put more than one layer of cardboard, stick them together, they become very solid structures. So people who can do woodworking can do this project with wood. This is going to be one solid piece. So now I'm taking two cardboard pieces and layering it together. So therefore I'll need two pieces of this. Then I'll need thinner strips, which is going to be slightly longer than this. So this is 7 inches in length and 1 inch wide. And I have taken 8 of the slices, 8 pieces. So 2 will join together and I'll get 4 pieces of this. And 2 will of this, which will join together and make 1 piece. And this is the shape of the bottle. This will be the side of the caddy, and this is 3.5 inches wide. Then I've taken my ruler and marked at 3 inches straight at 90 degrees on both the sides. I find out I found out the midpoint, and at the midpoint I took the height of the bottle and a little margin above it so that it's easy to pull the bottle out, and then which is approximately 10 inches. So from here till here it's 10 inches, and then I've added 1.5 inches more so that I can put the holding rod or the skewer or bamboo stick for holding the caddy. So that will come here in 1.5 inches block side. So below that is the section where the bottle will accommodate. So 1.5 inches, and this is 1.5 inches wide. So 1.5 inches straight, 1.5 inches going straight down, and then I join this point from 1.5 inches straight down to 3 inches straight. I make this slants. So this is how I construct this. I'll put a printout of this page in my blog post also. The link to my blog post, which will have the downloadable page of this, will be in my description box below the video. Now, this shape I have cut out 4 pieces, so 2 and 2 joined together. I'm using PVA glue or white glue. These are pretty strong glue and work on most of the surfaces. Not much, just to hold the 2 pieces together and stick it. Now these edges are not neat and I want it to be really solid. So I'm going to use some paper tape to stick it. Now I have added all of these pieces. They are like 2 slices of cardboard paper and then put together. So there are 8 of these slices, made 4, and this is 1 piece for the base and the 2 side pieces. Now I have to put them all together. I used both glue as well as paper tape for making this construction. I'll put similarly a second one here and then one on top of this here, and similarly these 2 pieces will go on the other side. This is the wooden towel or bamboo towel skewer, whatever, it's the one which is going to make the handle. Now the step that I forgot to do, that I should have done before I started making this construction, is making little holes here for the handle to go in. So just gonna first mark and then scoop it out using my X-Acto knife. Now for all cardboard constructions, one must be careful not to use scissors, because scissors destroy or crush it. It's always better to use X-Acto knife for these. So I'm just going to scoop out a little of one layer at least of the cardboard so that I can make the dowel go in. Similarly on the other side. This is how it looks so far. Next, I took an old book with yellowed text paper and tore some sheets of it, tore them into smaller pieces, and using some Mod Podge or diluted 1x1 part wood glue, I decoupaged these sheets, one layer overlapping the other on this caddy. I added a layer of this paper on the all the surfaces of the caddy, inside, out, all nooks and corners covered. This not only gives a very nice finish to the caddy, but also adds to its strength. I'm already liking the look of this old text paper caddy, and I can leave it like this, but I will go a step ahead. Once the layer of old text paper was dry, I found these printed papers. Some had some florals and some had red picket fence print on it. I added the red picket fence on the side bars, thin strip bars, and I added the floral print, one on each side. They merged very well with the background, and then finally I took some red acrylic paint and added some finishing touches. One can even add one extra layer of Mod Podge all over it to give a beautiful finish. The final step was to add the handle or the dowel. I added white glue on both sides of the dowel and inserted them into the little slots that I created on the sides of the caddy. Once dry, it's ready to use. I love how my caddy looks. It has got this vintage flair, it has got this cottage warmth. I love the text paper showing through and the decoupage print patterns of floral roses and the front picket fence. It's really cute. I can use it in many different ways, and you will be watching this caddy in my many decor videos which will come in future. Thank you everybody who have come and joined the challenge and watched the videos. I really appreciate your presence. I really appreciate your likes and comments. I would appreciate if you will subscribe to my channel if you're new here. Thank you very much for your time, and I'll see you soon in my next video. Take care.